my dears, you better know who you're dealing with. I'm the hootin'est, tootin'est, shootin'est bobtail wildcat in the West. I'm the fastest gun north, south, east, and west of the Pecos.
Shit it!
Mountain music, good old mountain music, played by a real hillbilly band. Vacation in the Ozarks, so quiet, so peaceful, so far from harm and danger, so... Huh? Oh, my Detroit, look what crawled out of the woodwork. What's up, Dad?
Welcome to Mutual of Omaha's Wild Kingdom.
Hey, little bunny rabbits. They just opened their eyes 2 days ago. The little cute itty bitty bunny rabbits mowing the lawn for the first time this year. And this was their nest. And two of them died. They became victim of the lawnmower. But these are our survivors. Say hello, YouTube. You little rascals. Oh, so soft. So soft. You little cute itty bitty thing. I know Miss Tina's coming out with some milk. She gonna bottle feed you. Oh, they smell something.
Let's see if they'll eat that. They don't even know it.
And this one just Mr. Curious George. That one back there looks pretty fat.
Yeah, this one, I think that one might have been the one that ate the carrot.
That hopped out this morning.
Yeah.
Oh, eating the milk, look at that.
What's up, Doc?
A rabbit? A rabbit!
Yes, a rabbit. Just who do you think you are?
Who am I? I'm Sam Von Schmam, the Hessian. That's who I am.
Go to town, Miss Rabbit. Miss Bugs Bunny. The other one's just chilling back there like a villain. Huh, I'm surprised that they're not being difficult to eat.
Well, some they were earlier. Sometimes they get difficult. This is actually the easiest it's been. This one was giving me a hard time earlier. The skinnier one.
Mm-hmm.
See, this is why I couldn't feed him earlier.
Oh, did you know itty bitty rabbit?
Entertainer.
Where did my Bubba go?
He's warming up. It got cold.
cute.
Just a little itty bitty love bunny.
Pardon? Pardon? Oh, no you don't! Get back in your seat!
Yes, sir! Yes, sir!
The first one that tries to get out of here to warn that rabbit gets his hide blown off! And that goes for the rest of you!
What did we get at the junkyard? So inside this door, the cables are broke, and so is the handle.
This handle is broke.
Inside this door, along with the cables and the bottom lock down here, was gone on this door. So gonna take the glass out of this one and put the glass in that one, and then put this door on here. But this door is came off of a E150 from Coastal Ford Mobile, Alabama. It's got a little urethane on it still that needs to be cleaned off. On that van that they had that door, had this door. The glass got broke, so I bought this door for $125. Look at that nice panel. Everything works. There is no rust. No rust on it at all. And this door cost me $45 at one junkyard. The third junkyard I went to, I had this one for $45. $45 for that. And keep in mind, now one cable comes down to the lock down here, and then another cable goes to a lock up here at the top. That's $30 for one cable, $30 for another cable, plus the handle that's broken on this door. That would have cost me, if I bought two cables with the handle and the lock at the bottom of the door, I would have spent $125 to buy all that brand new. So with a little bit of labor, used door, I pulled the door myself, it ended up costing me $45 instead. Now, so what had happened on this little giddy up deal here is that cabinet was rolling over these edges, and the cabinet tipped right over and ended up smacking the door right here.
Ken Roy is my name, Sam.
Okay, cut the jar. Not that away, you turn the loot.
Your first play. Come on, put down the card.
All right, don't rush me. I'm a thinker. And my head hurts.
Yeah, that's it. Ken, you lose.
And then last but not least from the junkyard, I acquired, there was already one on there. I acquired the proper headlight knob. I pulled it off of a van and I ended up cutting my finger here. See that big cut in my finger? So we'll get that original. Auto parts store didn't have this type of knob. They have those kinds of knobs.
So you dog-blasted, ornery, no-account, long-eared varmint!
Hey, just a minute, you! Them's fighting words!
Yeah, them's fighting words!
I dashed you to step across this line.
I'm a steppin'.
Gosh, I gotta clean this thing out. At least with this new door, I won't have to do this every time because the cable is broke on this door. So So I'll be able to open it up from the outside now, instead of having to reach my hand all the way up in here and after I unlock it. Oh, what a pain in the butt. There we go. So I got that one open, and now go back here and pull on this cable to open up that one, and then grab this cable in here to open up this one. Let's see, inside there. That part's broken. Right here where my thumb's coming through.
I'm giving you 1 second to draw a gun.
How's that, Chunky?
Say, that's a right smart picture you got there, partner. You know I'm fair to middling with a pencil myself. Look at here. Quit looking over my shoulder. It bothers me. There. How's that?
It stinks.
So we went to the junkyard yet again. They didn't. So these are my old doors. Two of my old doors and old rusty doors. This one, obviously the color doesn't match, so I only needed the inside. The license plate cover, you can see where the tag illuminating light housing was all broken. Plus on top of that, the handle that opened up was broken. This was broken, and so I just ripped out all the parts. This is my old lock. I verified that the lock was in here that worked. So, yeah, so there's the door fitted. And man, was that ever a pain in the derriere. So I now got a nice panel. It's rust-free. I did take my old lock out of my door and put my lock in there so that way I can lock it and unlock it. This is my original door. As you can see, this is the good Lord have mercy. This is the only door that I have not replaced yet. But I'm going to leave it as is for now. It still works and still functions, and the rust hasn't completely ate its way through, but once it does, I will eventually be replacing that one. So now we got two functioning side doors. I'm going to paint this window white like this one. I got some in my bag of Lowe's stuff. I got some more paint. The back. So this is my new license plate. I did swap this lock out as well, so that way I can use the, and now I have access. There's the panel. I now also have a speaker if I ever choose to wire it up for music back here in the back, and then a inside door handle, which I didn't have before. This is the door that I got off. I ended up taking it, was from a E150. I have a 250. Got that, the sticker lettering off, and ran out of the goof off stuff. So I still got to clean up all that sticky residue, but now the cables work, the locks work. So,
Take it, Sam!
My original plan was to get that diamond plate aluminum stainless steel to go over and sit over this whole hole. All raw materials. I got a price quote, and for 3 feet by 5 feet sheet of stainless steel was gonna be about $250 for 14 gauge. And then I got a quote for 16 gauge steel and have it. That one was actually $52, which is a lot more reasonable. $52 for an 8 foot by 4 foot sheet. And then I could cut it down to size, but then I would need to get the motor body mounts. These body mounts that go right here that I had a hell of a time. These guys. These are body mounts. They, these specific ones right here are $50 each. Found some on eBay for $29.99 a piece, but I'm gonna go a different route. That'd be $100 for the mounts, $52 for a sheet, and then angle iron to go across this to give it the support that it needs. Was going to be $132. So $132, $250. So roughly about $250 to do it with steel. To fix it properly with steel. I am going to be a cheapskate. Instead... And this should get me by for 1 year. And then in a year, I'll do it the right way. So this has cost me 60. So I got 3/4 inch of treated plywood. This is just regular 3/4, regular 3/4, not treated. But this one's treated. These 2 2x4s are treated 2x4s. So. The game plan is now. Dum da da dum. The game plan now is to take the 2x4s, two of them on high, going straight across here for my support. I have got Instead, I got these two bad to the bone carriage bolts that we're gonna put through my treated wood, treated wood and lumber. And I got, what else did I get? What did Daddy get from the store? So, I got them, fender washers, and nuts. Big, huge fender washers and nuts. So we're gonna take these carriage bolts, and it's gonna go through. We'll have these big fender washers on the inside down there. And then... I got some liquid nails, so I'm gonna take this liquid nail, make a bead, a liquid nail, all the way around this, all the way around this, and all the way around here of these liquid nail when I put that treated piece of wood down over this hole. And I'll also put the liquid nail between the 2 2x4s and on top, to keep the squeaks to a minimum, add for strength. And so I got 3 tubes of that liquid nail. We got 3 cans of great stuff. another can of that to paint the window. And then undercoating, rubberized, that's what I'm gonna paint this wood to help protect it from the elements. Let's get busy.
Captain!
Cavemen!
Here's our sheet of plywood cut a little bit for the treated. So I got my treated 2x4 wedged up underneath that lip there, and it's also wedged up underneath that. Got a hole drilled there, a hole drilled there. I have these other pieces of treated 2x4s that have been spray coated with the undercoating corrosion resistant dead and sand rubberized undercoating Rust-Oleum. Two cans of that did that little piece, and did those two treated 2x4s. Not 100% coverage. I think if I had one more can, I would have 100% coverage for this. So I cut these down. They're gonna fit in here like so, and it, I have to hammer it in to get it, and then I'm gonna screw those two pieces of wood together, and then drill another hole on the top of those for our long carriage bolts. And then I got this other piece here that I am going to be putting, where am I gonna put this stuff? Oh, this one is gonna go down here like this, and then have that carriage bolt going through it, and it will be screwed to that main one too. So we got those two, and then that's gonna create our support to support the top. We'll have it bolted in.
Dirty rabbit critters bound to be around here somewheres on account of our sees his footy prints.
Hey, there's the varmint now.
What's your hurry, boys?
Wahaha, Nelly!
You all care to practice with me for the square dancing tomorrow?
Delighted, ma'am.
Same likewise, I'm sure, ma'am.
All right, so we got all three pieces of wood sandwiched together, and got some hardwood right here. And then with this 1/8 piece, makes it level and flush with everything else. So I am now beginning my glue. Oh crap, this stuff is really, really messy. Oh crap. Oh, good catch. Good save.
Promenade across the floor, sashay right on out the door and into the glade, and everybody promenade.
Okay, ladies and gentle people. We have our carriage bolts in, which are replacing our body mounts. We have our spacers in to make us have a level
a level mounting attaching surface. We have drilled our hole so we can get access to our jack. And we have cut out our floor templates to where we want them to be cut out at. So now the next step to this wild and crazy adventure is to take those templates, put them on there, cut out that treated 3/4 inch wood, and put that bad boy on in there. So, let's see what else to show you. Oh, goodness. So, there's our double washer and new nut for where are we attached the body mounts. And some of that rubberized protective coating's coming off, as I kind of expected and anticipated, but we'll spray some more of that on there later. So now I got all my metal shelves out. So let me go ahead and get busy transferring, and I'll be back.
Shake like a hound dog, shake again. Wallow around in the old pig pen. Oh, wallow some more, you'll know how. Roll around like an old fat sow. Element left with your left hand. Follow through with the right and left grand. Now leave your partner the dirty old thing. Follow through with an elbow swing. Grab a fence post, hold it tight. Womp your partner with all your might. Hit him in the shin, hit him in the head. Hit him again, the critter ain't dead. Whop him low and whop him high. Stick your finger in his eye. Put a little rhythm, put a little sound. Bang your heads against the ground.
So there's my first fitting. Darn. Gotta turn off that radio.
First, I did some reading about it. I found a lot.
Gosh darn it, the sun is setting. There's never enough hours in a day. First fitting. Man. I made it too long. I'm gonna have to cut one of these ends. And I think it's gonna be this one. I can't get this in so this can come out. If you know what I mean, Vern.
Hey, Vern, how you feeling? Vern, I got you good news and I got you bad news. The bad news is your car is like totally totaled, okay? And the good news is now's a great time to buy a new one.
So, more trimming. Gosh, and that thing is heavy, folks. 3/4 inch, that big sheet. It is heavy.
Promenade all around the room, promenade like a bride and groom. Open up the door and step right in. Close the door and into a spin. Whirl, whirl, twist and twirl. Jump all around like a flying squirrel. Now, don't you cuss and don't you swear. Just come right out and form a square.
Okay, I cut it out. It is now officially dark, but I cut out the section, trimmed it up on the dry fitted. I had to do it two more times until we got a good fit. Then I came through with this liquid nails, heavy duty construction adhesive, waterproof, weatherproof. So, as you can see, we got a big, huge clopper, lovely giddy up. Now I'm gonna save this ledge to last until I get it put in place. Then I'll lift it up and squeeze some underneath there. So let me manhandle this big piece in here, and we'll show you what it looks like after. Darn plane. Ta-da! Oh man,
I'm out of breath. That was a job. So, I gotta hurry up and screw this thing down. Now, goodness, I'm out of breath. So, what I'm gonna do is screw this leading edge down first, and then I'm gonna come back and go underneath and screw the metal to the wood from underneath with some self-tapping metal screws. So I gotta get after it before that wood starts drying. I'll show you after I'm done.
Your home, bow to your partner, bow to the gent across the hall, and that is all.
Y'all come back now, here.